In this video, we're going to look at playback configuration settings on the S-Play. This was added in version 1.6. Firstly, we're going to navigate across to the settings page, and then scroll down to find the playback configuration box. Here we've got two options: send black frame on playlist stop, and restrict to one active playlist per group. Firstly, we're going to look at send black frame on playlist stop. Now, as the name suggests, when this is enabled, the S-Play will send a black frame across all channels and universes whenever stop all is pressed. If you want to send zero value channels for just the playlist that you're using, we recommend going into the playlist settings and then setting a fade out time of greater than 0 seconds on the playlist. This is really useful for installations where you're using LED pixel tape. For example, if you stop a playlist, the streaming ACN, DMX or ArtNet that you're sending out will be cut at that point. Now, if you're using a pixel controller, this means that the last state will persist. If you want everything to go black when you're stopping the playlist, you need to send a black frame. If using fixtures on your project that don't have zero as a default home position, such as moving lights, we don't recommend enabling this setting. Doing this can cause the fixture to spin around to its end stop whenever stop's pressed. Next, let's move on to restrict to one active playlist per group. So to illustrate this, I've created two static cues. The first one's green, and the second one you can see here is blue. Now, I've set these to work on RGBW tape, which we're going to have a look at later. So if I navigate over to playlists, I've got my green scene and my blue scene. I've made a playlist for each of them. Now, they're both 10 seconds long, and they contain no start trigger, no stop trigger. Once I press play, it'll just continue to loop. Note that the internal priority is 100 and the group is 0 for both of these. We can see down the bottom under playback configuration that restrict to one active playlist per group is turned off. So back to the playlist page. I'm going to press play on the green scene. And that's come on my bench with the Octo and some pixel tape set up. Now if I play the blue scene, we get a cyan mix between the green and the blue both acting at the same time. If I stop the green scene, we can see it's gone fully blue. Play that once again, goes back to cyan. So let's say we only want to play back one color at a time. So if I go over to settings, and then now I turn on restrict one active playlist per group, and update the playback configuration. When we go back to playlists, and I stop these, now when I play, you can see it snap to green, play blue, and it snaps to blue. Now to make this look a bit nicer, what we can do is start modifying these playlists. So I'm going to select blue scene, and we'll put a 2 second fade in on that globally for the playlist, and a 2 second fade out too. Press save. I'll do the same thing for green as well. And save there. So now when we start to play, we can see that smooth fade in at the beginning, and when I press stop, it's going to fade out. Now we add on the playback settings on top, and I can have my blue scene, and I can play green. Now what you can see this doing is it's sending the stop command and then fading out over that 2 second period to make sure things look smooth. If working on a larger project, this comes in handy by setting different groups for different areas of your project. For example, if working on a hotel project, you may want to set the front facade of the building to be one group, whereby you could allow different colours to be recalled at different times. Another group could control a social area or a bar, and another one for the foyer. This allows the user to recall states they want to see without having to stop other playlists first. If you've got any questions, get in contact through the comments or drop a message to our sales and support team. Thanks for watching and see you on the next video.